So the first one with a real dart, Pfizer. And then there are two people I've placed on the dartboard, but I've used Velcro for them. Velcro darts, right? But I put them on there. Anthony Fauci. And Bill Gates.
I can be really great because I'm a Victorian. So yeah, and I'll put the Velcro dart for Daniel Evans.
Why are we doing this if we're not trying to do it for the right reasons? There's a lot of things you can do in life, whatever it is, but if you're given the privilege of sitting in Parliament, and it is a privilege, it's an absolute privilege, and you don't do this sort of stuff at the time, then what's the point?
Alex, we hear that all the time.
He delivered the truth that you gave him to pronounce in relation to the inauthenticity of the COVID vaccines. He pronounced that to an empty House of Commons. Now that must have been frustrating for you, but doesn't it give you an index of how far in we are to dealing with institutions that have lost their way?
Yeah. The only beneficiaries from vaccine mandates were Big Pharma. The second thing is this individual is now saying, Asim, you need to go and give evidence to the COVID inquiry, and I will do everything in my power to make sure that you meet with the chair of the COVID inquiry and that happens. So things are moving in the right direction. I think we're at a tipping point. Honestly, we're getting closer to the point. We have to keep pushing, but I think like the collapse of Lehman Brothers or whatever else, I think suddenly what's going to happen is you're going to see this massive shift and change, and I honestly hope with what they've done and what they've been doing for a long time, I think Pfizer are going to collapse faster than Lehman.
Thank you. haven't been turning up for requests to come for boosters. It dropped massively in the UK. Even their doctors were telling them they were ignoring that advice. So the public know, and I think that the awareness already that is creeping out there is already a win. But we just keep fighting for the truth. We stand up, we do our best as individuals to have conversations, difficult conversations with friends and family members, right? But we have to do it from a place of compassion. I know it's not easy, right? Have empathy and just get through to even one person that you can change the mind of. It has a ripple effect, right? It has a ripple effect. And before you know it, we will burst this bubble. That's what I think. So let's keep going. We have to make sure that we get through this process with as peaceful a way as possible. My concern, this isn't handled properly and this isn't the right leadership there. We are heading towards anarchy and chaos. Now, there will be a degree of chaos, right? We've had pathological order, and there needs to be chaos to get us out of pathological order to non-pathological order. And there will be, and we have to accept that, but we have to do it in as most peaceful way as we possibly can.